I wake up, every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep. Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. And I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me.
Bonkers.
Run! 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 Run!
I wake up.
Here we are in Manchester. It's under 20. It's about to start. As you can see, the fires are mad.
Number four.
Everyone's rooting for their borough and their town.
D. Backwards.
Bonkers.
Some people think I'm
from Manchester.
The last what? Race of the
2019 international final. Not me.
I hear
you
going,
number
37
in the under
32. Every day is a daydream. Everything in my life ain't what it seems. I wake up just to go back to sleep. I act real shallow, but I'm in too deep.
Bong, 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 bong.
Some people think I'm
normally I take part in like 75, 100, 200 and long jump.
Yeah.
And when I heard about this the first time, I was excited.
So where did you hear it from?
Central Park, near my local area. And that was it.
So how long have you been involved in street
athletics? Last year, I came third in Manchester.
Oh, wow.
And like, when I'd done it, I felt confident. Now I'm sitting down here, I'm so scared. I don't know why.
There's no warning.
So
you're
going to make 2012?
On your mark.
Yeah, I'm in the Junior Olympics for 2012.
Oh, is it?
Yoo-hoo! Bong, bong, okay. Bong, 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 bong.
Some people think I'm bonkers, but I just think I'm free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me. Some people pay for thrills, but I get mine for free. Man, I'm just living my life, there's nothing crazy about me.
I'm here with Darren Campbell. Today's been such a great event. Like, how do you feel about all the energy and the crowds? How do you think the day went?
For me, I think it's been the best street athletics so far. It's the fifth year. Each year we try and make it more and more exciting, and we brought in the whole team trophy, which is a street sign, and as you can see, all the young people had a great time. And for me, that's really what it's about. The energy was fantastic today, the performers were brilliant, and I think that just makes the day that bit more special.
So, like, how did it come about? Like, how did it start?
Myself and Lynford, going back 6 years ago, we were sat around the table thinking how we could give something back to young people. I knew that we had an opportunity to gain support if we came up with the right idea from Manchester because of Commonwealth Games. So we went to them with the concept of street athletics, going to council estates and putting on races for the kids. And then it developed into, okay, let's do talent.
Yeah.
Like talent shows kind of thing, and then that's where the singing and the music and all of that came. And then from because of the success, then Sony got involved, and then we got the media side of things.
Yeah.
So then the young people were able to become, you know, part of the whole media aspect of it all. And it, you know, as many, for me, it's about giving as many opportunities as possible to young people.
So how do you think it's changed your life, and most importantly the youths that take part and participate in street athletics?
Well, athletics changed my life, and I know the power of athletics, and I know what it taught me, and I've been able to travel the world, so that's been fantastic. So for me, it's about giving these young people an opportunity. It's up to them to grab that opportunity, but I believe what goes on here is massive. As you could see, the joy the joy from them. I'm coming. The joy from them coming third and winning the PSB, that just shows, you know, the power of what we're doing. How I view life is, you know, go out there, deliver, and you receive your reward.
Mm-hmm. One request,
can I
have a
myself, Darren, and the team, enough respect. We were fighting hard in your corner, and it was bigger and better. So we're hoping that next year, it'll be even bigger still. Thank you all for coming out. Safe journey, and we'll see you next year.
Today's been a great day. Like, how do you feel about all the energy and everything that's going on today?
Well, I mean, it's been absolutely terrific. You know, when we started this 5 years ago, you know, we would never have thought you'd be 5 years on, we'd be on, we'd be here doing it. And, you know, it's not even about how I feel or how anyone else feels, it's about how the kids feel. And you can see on their faces, the kids were winning, they're smiling, the kids were at the back are smiling, the parents are loving it. So that tells us it's been a success.
So what inspired you to start Street Advocacy?
Well, I mean, Darren and I, we were sitting down one day and we were talking about how we got into sports.
Yeah.
And we were putting the world to right and everything else, and we thought, you know, we race kids. We found that we race kids on our street. We do the same thing as these guys are doing, and look where we got to. So we felt that if we can give them the opportunity that we had, then maybe, who knows, they can achieve, you know, as much as we've done. So we just put it on, and it's tremendous.
So how do you feel it's changed, how it's changed your life and the lives of, more importantly, the lives of the youths?
Well, I mean, it's changed the lives of youths because we've had some tremendous feedback from, you know, parents, you know, writing to us, and the kids, you know, writing to us. I mean, we've had kids who, some of them have never been off their estates before, you know, so we call them the posters, bring them to Manchester, and it's opened their eyes. We took them to Paris, and they can see some of the top guys perform. Exactly, and you see the faces, and they, you know, because we want to give them the inspiration that they too, if they work hard, can do this. You know, the sky's the limit if you go out there and work hard. And, you know, that's all I always say, it's cheaper than life insurance.
Yeah.
So, you know, you look after the kids and then everything else, you know, will fall into place.
Okay, thank you for your time. I've got one last request
for you. No problem at all.
Thank you.
This wasn't part of the interview.
Maybe we should get you to do street athletics next year.